Have you ever felt sick after being exposed to molds? Don't worry, you're not alone. Being exposed to specific molds can affect our human health and well-being. But as people are unique, how it affects us can differ from person to person. Today, we're going to talk about the health effects of mold exposure. But before we get into it, do me a favor and smash the like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell button for notifications whenever a new video is published. So without further ado, let's talk about what molds are. A mold is a fungus that consists of microscopic life forms that can be found anywhere. They can be pretty colorful, as they can be black, white, orange, green, and purple. Molds are crucial in nature because they decompose dead plants and trees. Molds grow in moist environments and multiply by spreading spores throughout the atmosphere, so you're probably exposed to molds daily without you even knowing about it. Like your family, mold spores are generally safe in small doses. But when they land in an environment where they can develop, they can begin to spread. We can only hope it won't be in our homes. In addition, mold spores can be emitted into the air, where they can be easily breathed in. So if you're allergic to mold and inhale a lot of spores, you would probably have many problems in regards to your health. Like people, molds need to eat too, and that's why they stay in places where they can grow healthy, such as walls, floors, appliances, carpet, and more. But what molds can't live without is moisture. So like a moth to a flame, they are attracted to damp and moist areas. So if you ever want to see them, they're mostly chilling in your bathrooms, laundry rooms, basement, or crawl spaces. Now that you probably have some clue of what molds are, let's get back to our main topic. As I've mentioned before, human illnesses can be caused by exposure to some molds, and this can also have adverse effects on the human health. Molds can have different effects on your body. If you're sensitive to it, it can affect immune responses that may cause you to have allergies. You can also be affected by having direct contact with the molds themselves, and last but not least, you can be harmed from mycotoxins, toxic products made by molds. So there are different ways for molds to affect your physical health. For each of these modes of transmission, there is a scientific basis that is documented from real mold-related diseases affecting humans. It has been objectively and clinically tested that molds can actually harm our well-being. Scary, right? But we're not done yet. As Pokemon do, they can also evolve, and scientists have predicted that there can be more new illnesses related to these little creatures compared to what we have now. This has become an apparent issue, as many people strongly believe that indoor mold exposure can cause different illnesses, although evidence of such is absent. We can't really rule it out. After all, many causes of diseases were unproven until it was. That's science for you. Molds' mycotoxin toxicity. Molds excrete harmful substances known as mycotoxins, which are substances produced by fungus in specific environments. At its production, these environmental factors influence the development of mycotoxins. When living organisms are exposed to enough mycotoxins, they can be sick, or worse, they can die. Extreme exposure to extremely high amounts of mycotoxins can cause neurological disorders that can lead to death. Luckily, such directions are highly unusual, even in homes with significant mold problems. Long-term exposure on a daily basis, for example in your house or your workplace, can be dangerous. Farmers working with moldy wheat can have severe reactions towards molds as they are around it all day. Mycotoxins can be located on mold spores and mold particles. Therefore, they can also be seen on the mold substrate. Ingestion, skin exposure, and inhalation are all possible routes of entry for these toxins, so better be sure to look out for these toxins. Molds and asthma. Molds cause a lot of allergic reactions. They can happen right away or take a while. People with mold allergies may experience asthma episodes as a result of mold exposure. So naturally, they should avoid any contact and be exposed to molds. Mold exposure can also affect people without allergies, but a more severe reaction can be seen with people who have. But even if you don't have the allergy, it can still irritate your skin, eyes, throat, and even nose. But oh, on the bright side, current research indicates that being exposed to mold outdoors cannot cause allergic rhinitis. The silver lining, right? In a case where you want to know if you're allergic or not, you must do a clinical evaluation where patients with suspected mold allergies should be tested for IgE antibodies to specific mold antigens using a clinical method of the skin or blood testing. Molds fungal infections. Fungal infection is a severe health concern from mold exposure for susceptible people. Individuals with weak immune systems who are exposed to high amounts of mold or who have been exposed to mold for a long time may become severely sick. Infections are usually prominent in the sinuses and gastrointestinal tract, but lung and skin problems can also occur. The invasive mold may or may not create mycotoxins. Let's all hope that it won't. Additional effects of mold on people's health. As I've said, people react differently to molds, and that's why exposure to it can lead to various health effects, and in some cases, there can be no reaction at all. Let's just hope that we're the latter. Some health effects are severe, and some are not. It really depends on your immune system. In 2004, as reported by the Institute of Medicine, household mold exposure was linked to upper respiratory problems, cough, and wheeze. However, people who have previous illnesses have a more severe reaction, like people who have asthma or hypersensitivity pneumonitis. By 2009, the WHO's guidelines for indoor air quality, dampness, and mold provided additional information for the masses. Other recent research has revealed a relation between early mold exposure and asthma's development in some children, especially among children who may be genetically predisposed to asthma. Some housing countermeasures can reduce asthma and respiratory allergies risk. Other negative health effects, such as acute idiopathic pulmonary hemorrhage in babies, memory problems, or fatigue, have not been proven to be related to molds, including the infamous toxic black mold. As always, more research is needed to determine what causes these adverse effects on health. Mold does not have any blood tests. Some doctors can perform allergy testing for mold allergies, but no clinically established test can specify the time and place a mold exposure occurred. Although scientists are divided on whether indoor mold causes harmful health impacts, most tend to agree that spending time in damp, moist areas might lead to respiratory ailments like allergies, asthma, cough, runny nose, and sinus problems. However, additional research is necessary to confirm if these disorders are caused by mold, mold byproducts, dust mites, chemicals produced from decaying surfaces, or household air pollution. To an average person who just wants to live and work in a peaceful environment, this may appear to be an irrelevant scientific problem. But don't forget that there are a lot of reasons to maintain indoor areas clean and dry, regardless of whether researchers agree if these illnesses are caused by molds or not. I mean, who wants a damp house? Only Shrek would live in a place like that. Keeping your home mold-free begins with identifying the sites where increased moisture may appear. Then, take the proper actions to remove those sources. Remove any mold that may already be present and keep the area dry afterward to prevent new mold growth would be the best way to handle the mold. People who believe and think they are sick should immediately seek professional care to have a good diagnosis and a suitable treatment plan, rather than relying on self-proclaimed experts who promote unproven cures online. It's better to hire people who are skilled and competent regarding one's health, right? So those are the effects of mold on people's health. As we are already at the end of the video, it's essential to know who would be most affected by molds. Who is at risk from molds? As I've mentioned, people who have severe mold allergies may experience more severe symptoms, such as shortness of breath, similar to those who have asthma. These are the people who should watch out for mold. Others who should also watch out for mold are people who are much older with weak immune systems, children and infants who are also immunocompromised, as well as people whose immune responses have been weakened by HIV infection, cancer, liver disease, lung disease, or chemotherapy. Have you ever encountered such mold problems? Do you think you're one of the people who would be at risk? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And before leaving, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button for notifications on our future content. With that being said, see you in the next one.